Today I'm going to talk about maybe the most often asked question I get on pre-market prep, the live stream I do every day, 8:30 Eastern on YouTube, Facebook, everywhere. But it's the number one question, and I think it's a great question. So I want to take a few minutes to answer it as well as explain the why. Lead Training with Stocks to Trade, Tim Bohen here. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share these videos with your friends. And also, if you're on YouTube or any of the social medias, you know, ring that bell, turn your notifications on, because we put out so much content right now. As I mentioned in the intro, I go live every single trading day at 8:30 Eastern, talking about the stocks of the day, so it's very topical. We're dropping multiple podcasts a week. We're dropping these how-to videos. There's so much out there. I want you to be notified, so ring that bell. Then also, if you've been checking out these videos, if you like them, if you're interested in learning more, click below, check out the Steady Trade team. It's a mentorship program where I do two daily webinars every single trading day, answer every single question, work with a small group to really hone in these skills and drive home these rules, one of which we're going to talk about today. So you might be on pre-market prep, and a lot of the sketchier stocks, I say wait till 9:45 or later. Now, keep in mind that is a window, okay? That is one thing I did want to answer on this video. A lot of people think it's like precisely, you know, and it's not precisely, but it's kind of like basically what we're trying to do is get past the market open. So it's like 9:40 to 10 a.m.-ish. I call it the 9:45 rule just as a shorthand method. You know, it's much quicker to say 9:45 rule than it is to say, hey, sometime after the market open, but not too late in the day, you know, 9:40 to 10 a.m.-ish. It takes a little long to say, especially when you're doing rapid fire. So that being said, it is a window, roughly about a 20-minute window from that 9:40 time until that 10 a.m. window. And now why? What is the why? That's something I always try and focus on. I don't just throw out stocks. I don't just throw out concepts, vocabulary. I always try and give you, you know, what's the why? What's the reason for that? You can see ACY, a stock, both back-to-back days was in play in the morning. Actually, it was in play the last week too. But you can see yesterday spiked huge at 9:45 and then continued $3, $4 to $5 higher once it broke that high a day at $12 a share at, oh geez, exactly 9:43. So not bad. I was just using this because it's a recent example. I was thinking it was a little later in the day, but 9:43 a.m. spiked through that high a day and then continued over $5 a share higher. Then vice versa, you can see today it tried at 9:45 and failed. That is actually one of the biggest things I like about the 9:45 rule, is something it does, especially for newer traders, it keeps you out of trouble, okay? And listen, I know you want to make money, you know, you want to make 100 bucks, 1000 bucks, 10,000, a million today, you know, not realistic goals, okay? Let's have realistic goals. But ultimately, you're here to make trades to make money, but especially when you're new, so much of being successful and staying in the game is doing less. I think that one of the biggest things that new traders struggle with is, you know, if you've got a good work ethic, which I hope you do. That's why you're watching these videos. You know, a lot of people come in and they think, well, the more I do, the better. You know, if you're digging a ditch, the more you do, the better. If you're delivering packages, driving Uber, you know, or what, working, you know, assembling cars, you know, anything manual particularly, or even knowledge work. I mean, the more lines of code you program, the more websites you build, you know, we're all programmed with this more is more is more. And that's how you get better. You know, hey, boss, I coded, you know, 10,000 lines last week and everybody else on the team coded 5,000. Give me a promotion. Give me a raise. But with trading, especially when you're new, it's doing less because it's avoiding those mountains and mountains of losses. You're going to lose at the beginning. You're going to lose over and over and over again. And actually, you're going to lose forever. Okay, losing is part of trading. But when you're new, you're going to go on stretches where you lose over and over and over again. And if you're trying to do too much, you can't track your data. You know, you don't know what's working and what's not. Is trading low price working? Is trading high price working? You know, what is actually working for you? And that's why you have to really focus on tracking your data and keeping track of what actually works. The 945 rule keeps you out of trouble, just like ACY today, because so many of these momentum stocks, especially in the world we're in with the chat pumps and the Reddit pumps, we see so many of these chat pumps at 9 a.m. They try and run these stocks up at, right into the open, and then they dump them. And we see that all the time with the chat rooms. And newbie traders don't know what's going on. They see the stock spiking in pre-market, 8:45, 9. They get excited. They start buying. They don't realize it's a chat pump. Market opens 9:30 a.m. The bottom falls out, and they're like, what's going on? What's going on? Well, the chat just dumped it. And that's what we're seeing right now. That window, that 9 a.m. to the market open window, it just repeats and it repeats with the momentum stocks of the day. You get that big spike early, then that yank. And so many people get bagged, bag holders, you know, holding the bag, as they say, because they jump in too early. Now, if you wait for that 9:45 confirmation, I call it, doesn't mean the trade's guaranteed. You know, doesn't mean like, oh, I'm always going to win if I wait for 9:45. But if we go back to, you know, ACY yesterday, this spiked early in pre-market at 6 a.m., pulled back, and then broke out of that move in the 9:45 window. And that is your confirmation move. And you can also see huge volume candle. So now by waiting and avoiding that early chop, you now know that everybody's thinking the same thing. Everyone's like, hey, this thing is just made that move again after the market opened. Veteran traders know. I mean, you'll hear this saying all the time. I use it a lot. Amateurs open the market, professionals close it. Okay, write that one down. That's your 1% better for today. But veteran traders know. Most veteran traders don't trade right at the market open. You get so many whipsaw, choppy moves. You can even be right, you know, like ACY yesterday. But if you're in too early, if you're buying at 6, 7 a.m., it yanks to the downside and you're trapped and you lose. Then you see the stock spike later, giving you that volume, giving you that move and bringing in all the buyers. That's why we love this, is everyone's thinking the same thing. That's another key point I want to make in momentum trading. You're not trying to find something undiscovered. Okay. The more buyers you have, the more people that are piling into the stock, the higher the likelihood it's going to go from 12 to 17, or, you know, these days, 20, 25, 30. You know, we see some 3, 4, 5,000% moves these days. So wait for that move. And then also that heightens your probability of success, in my opinion. You then have a clear stop down on VWAP. When we're trading these, we almost always use VWAP for that stop. So if the stock rips through, you buy and it fails. Maybe there's news. Maybe there just aren't enough buyers. It pulls back, touches VWAP, you move on. Very, very clean cut trading plan. Okay? So focus on 9:45 for entries. Focus on VWAP for exits. Then use your 3-to-1 risk to reward methodology, something I talk about in the Steady Trade team all the time. It's a mathematical way we calculate our goals and our stops. So check out the Steady Trade team if you want more info. That's tuck-in entries. Now, my favorite part of the 9:45 rule, and again, you might not like this. This might be the unpopular part. It keeps you out of trouble, just like ACY today. It tried to break the high of the day at 9:45 and failed. So that would have been a no trade, a no entry. And look at what it did. I mean, look at the stock now. It's now $5 a share lower than it was at that double top at 16. Looks like it's going to go red on the day. I mean, if this stock is up from, I think, $2. Yeah, up from $2 three days ago, about to go red on the day. This thing's probably going to get destroyed into the market close today and probably gap down tomorrow. Are you wishing you were in this stock? Or are you wishing you bought at 9:35 or 9:40, pre-9:45? Or are you like, whoa, glad the 9:45 rule kept me out of trouble on this one. I avoided the trade. I'm not bagged. I'm not justifying. I mean, listen, as new traders, we all know one of the biggest things newbie traders struggle with is sticking to that stop loss. A lot of people would still be in this, even though I think they're crazy and I would beg them not to. They're still scanning for news, trying to draw support and resistance lines. asking people on Twitter, hey, what do you think about ACY? You know, no, it's busted. It's dead. You can't stay in these things. But if you'd followed the rule, you stuck to it, you would have never been in it today. You'd never be upside down, and you'd never be holding and hoping and begging or praying that there's some news to come out. So that being said, drop me a comment. Let me know if you like these rules-based ideas, rules-based techniques. I do a ton of time-dependent trading, okay? A lot of what I teach, a lot of what I do, there's different ways to approach all through the day, you know, whether it be pre-market, at the open, 9:45, midday, 2 p.m. You'll hear me talk about 2 p.m. is another very active window we look to trade. Then you go into the market close, then after hours. There's a whole different methodology depending on what time of day it is. And I think that's something that I don't hear get talked about that much. I think it's one of the most pivotal things that people need to learn is you do different things in the morning than the afternoon. Different sizing, okay, different position size, different chart patterns, different volatility levels. You know, we tend to focus on the crazy volatile movers in the morning, then the slower mover grinders, we call them, in the afternoon. So check out the Steady Trade team to learn more about that. And definitely get on pre-market prep. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And 8:30 Eastern every day. Have a great day.